Welcome to week seven. So we're 2 weeks from the end and we're going into week three now with the daily improvement log system. So how's that been going for you? At this stage now, the neuroplasticity should start kicking in, where the brain's ability to change its own structure to form new neural pathways based on what you've been practicing up to this point. That is obviously dependent on the effort that you put in to date. Have you been working with the exercises from week one, doing it at least 4 to 5 days a week, rolling into week two, three, and so forth. And it all converges into the daily improvement log system, okay? Now, don't worry if you haven't. I know we all have busy schedules, but if you have, it should start kicking in around now or maybe now next week or two. But if you haven't, just be patient. You're gonna have to just stay with it a little bit longer. But don't be getting agitated or anxious about it, because that will cut it off straight away, okay? You gotta let it flow. So last week we said we'd have a closer look at dealing with challenges effectively. So I've chosen a personal experience of mine, one that is very much a driving force behind flow buoyancy and my involvement in the flow state, personal development, sports psychology, and so forth. Okay, so let's take a look. So back in 2006, I was working on a project that didn't go very well, to say the least. I was working in an environment where there was no contract in place. We didn't know what the client wanted because there was no proper design. And this created an environment where it wasn't open to any kind of collaboration in terms of any positive collaboration or open communication. Because the proper structures weren't there, people were afraid to commit to anything. So very quickly, the job became very, very difficult in the sense that you couldn't rely on anybody to assist you in any way, shape or form, where you normally would be able to rely on people to assist or coordinate with you, okay? So this made the job all the more difficult in terms of when you're going home in the evenings, you're not feeling like you've contributed, you don't feel that sense of achievement, you're not getting the dopamines, you're not getting the endorphins, you're not getting the serotonin, you're not getting the oxytocin, because nobody's pulling together as a proper team. All you've got going really is cortisol, okay, because you're running against a brick wall every day and this is generating a lot of stress, a lot of anxiety, okay? And I found myself in a situation where this created the perfect storm in my life, because I was very driven, and coupled that with not being able to achieve what I wanted to achieve and the fact that I was drinking probably about 8 cups of coffee with 2 sugars in each one every day, and I was also having some energy drinks in on top of that. So this, as I say, created the perfect storm in a sense that I started suffering from anxiety disorder for about a 3 month period, and I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy. I was not able to sleep at night. I was lying in bed. I couldn't even stay in the bed. I had to jump out of the bed and sometimes go outdoors. If I was in the car and I get into a traffic jam, I wasn't able to stay in the car. I had to get out. I found myself in meeting rooms when the door closed that I'd have to bail out of the room. I can laugh at it now, but it certainly wasn't funny at the time. And that coupled with the particular environment where you were frustrated in the sense that you couldn't do your job properly, and there was a lot of mudslinging going on because people were blaming each other. So everyone's confidence dropped and everyone's credibility took a knock, okay? So take that scenario, and I've basically put that in. Now, I didn't have the dealing with challenges effectively system back then, but if I retrospectively put it in there now, this is what I would be putting in there. So dealing with challenges effectively, what is the challenge? Well, my career and my health and well-being were at a crisis point, okay, to say the least. What is helping and what is working? Okay, now obviously you would do this when you get coherent, reset and refocus. So what is helping and what is working? Well, at least I was aware that I needed to do something fast and I was willing and open to change. And I also had a loving, supporting family behind me. Okay? They were the positives. And what was not helping and not working? Well, obviously the environment was not conducive to any kind of positive collaboration or any kind of collaboration or communication or coordination. I didn't have the tools either to deal with anxiety. Obviously the coffee, 8 cups a day with 2 sugars in each, and the energy drinks full of sugar, certainly causing a problem there. I also had a loss of interest in my career. And I found I had no spark anymore, okay? And any unhelpful thoughts or core beliefs around this challenge? Well, I very quickly started thinking I'm useless in a career sense, and also being able to handle the stress. Okay, I had a wife, three kids, two mortgages, and it was a very unstable period. I didn't know what the future was going to be. Was I going to be able to continue doing my job? I felt I needed to get out of engineering. So let us look at more realistic alternative thoughts or core beliefs around this challenge. Well, up to that point, my career was going well. My CV read well. I was on some high profile projects up to that point. Also paying a lot of emphasis on music, trying to make it in music in the background, which was certainly getting in the way. I was taking on too much. And I needed to have the tools to combat stress, to intervene with stress, like the coherence technique. If I'd had that back then, I certainly would have been able to cope better. Okay, so I needed better coping tools. And basically, I needed to reinvent myself and my career in terms of upskilling and retooling. Okay, so I felt there was possibly four choices on the table, or four options. The first would be continue on and do nothing. Obviously not sustainable from a personal health point of view and from a career point of view. Secondly, I could take the contract that was offered in Dubai, but that was running from the issue and probably going to create more stress in the long run. The third was change career completely. Not really an option when you've got three kids and two mortgages to support. And again, it's running from the issue. So the fourth option I went with, which was continuing on in the same career path, but obviously I needed to change things. I needed to upskill and retool. Okay, so perceiving the challenge directly, what are the best corrective actions to take, if any? Well, what I came up with was to retool with personal effectiveness, sports psychology, and relevant ancient wisdom systems. Okay, to also build on past experiences and strip it back to a point where it was working previously, and use that as a platform to move forward again. And to rebuild my confidence in my self-abilities and also my credibility and also my health as well, okay? So the big lesson or opportunity from that, looking back, would be to deal with challenges when they are small and manageable, okay? As soon as I started to notice that this particular project was troublesome and causing problems, well, I had a choice. I could have changed jobs, or I could have sat down with my senior management, or I could have started to retool straight away, okay? I may have prevented 3 months of dealing with anxiety disorder. Okay, so next steps and actions and fine-tuning. Well, I had to research and find the best personal effectiveness systems out there, including those in the sports psychology and ancient wisdom systems. And I decided to learn from the greats, okay, and stand on the shoulders of giants. And that's exactly what I did. I spent the next number of months researching those best systems, seeking out the greats, and within a very short period of time, I went from struggling in middle management to standing out and thriving at a senior management level on projects in excess of 1 billion euros. Okay, and I found very quickly I was being headhunted by various clients because they noticed the effectiveness. Okay. And it also brought a lot of respect for my peers, my colleagues, which I'd lost previously on the other project, remember? I now was in a position where, by default, I was becoming a leader, because when we were faced with challenges, I had the tools now to see beyond the challenges and focus on the process of achieving the best solution. And people follow that. As we said previously, people don't follow chaos. Well, sometimes they do, but they don't do it for too long. They would rather follow somebody who is calm, measured, focused on the process, and in a light-hearted way, not too serious, okay? I just thought it was apt to share these quotes from Mary Kay Ash and Arthur C. Clarke. So don't limit yourself. Many people limit themselves to what they think they can do. You can go as far as your mind lets you. What you believe, you can achieve. The only way of discovering the limits of the possible is to venture a little way past them into the impossible. Arthur C. Clarke. Great quotes. So remember, stand on the shoulders of giants. If you find yourself in a situation or a challenge, seek out what your role models did in similar situations, or maybe something you did previously that got you out of a similar situation. Okay? And the more you do that, the more you visualize past these challenges, the more resilient you're going to become. This is what will be the way you do business going forward. It's like anyone who's achieved anything of notoriety, all the greats, they decided to achieve what they achieved. They weren't assisted all the way along the path. They certainly had key influential people along the way, but they were so driven themselves. It was a switch inside them. They decided they were going to achieve greatness, and they never lost the vision of achieving that greatness. The people who sustain this greatness and have longevity in their careers are the ones that don't get caught up with the trappings or the money side of things, the material side of success. They always stayed focused and stayed hungry on staying with that greatness. Okay. As soon as they start to allow the trappings to become an interference or a distraction, that's when they started to basically fall from the top. And some of them, that did happen to, but they still had the ability to refocus and retool again to get back on the track for greatness. Okay. So that's it for this week. So again, over the course of the coming week, keep fine-tuning. Okay. And with your to-do list, just try and fine-tune that in more detail in terms of what you choose from your high-level to-do list and where you put it in terms of into what ultradian rhythm, okay? And if you find yourself not achieving all that you set out to achieve in the 90 minutes, don't let it go to your head. Don't get frustrated. Don't get agitated. You may be over-ambitious, or there's no problem just moving it into another ultradian rhythm period, okay? And dealing with challenges effectively, another pointer for you. Try and visualize the solution to the problem in terms of visualizing coming up with the best solution to the problem in a timely manner as often as you can. You don't have to visualize the detail, just visualizing coming up with the solution to the problem, because that will help you keep out of your own way and not let it go to your head. Okay? It's like what they say with achievements, don't let them go to your head. The same with challenges, don't let them go to your head, because as soon as you do, you put off the flow and you can't go with the flow of the challenge itself. And that's the key, is to allow your whole body intelligence assist you coming up with the best solution for the challenge. Okay? So have a good week. Take care.